People think the world of your father and the tremendous ministry that he had. Tell me about your observations growing up in a pastor's home, especially someone that had that strong of a ministry. What are some of your observations from growing up in the same home as David Wilkerson?
Well, I just absolutely loved my father. We got along close. We were friends, co-workers. He was a dad, a mentor. And just to be able to watch his life and ministry, the two together, I think, is what really made sense to me. Is what was really important to me to see that the way he lived his life out in his ministry, he lived it out in his personal life. So to see his integrity, what he preached, he lived. He loved not only people who were lost and hurting down out in the streets, but he loved his family. He loved my mom, his wife, for 50-something years. They were together as best friends. And loving Jesus, that was the centrality of Jesus Christ. I don't think I've ever met another man in my life who was more focused on just loving Christ and having a heart for Jesus and a heart for the poor and the lost and the needy. One other thing that just comes to mind is faith. He was a man of faith. He just believed that God could do the impossible. Nothing was too difficult for the Lord. And he would try to throw himself into the most difficult of settings just to prove how good and wonderful and miraculous God is.
In the heart of New York City, the ministry that he was doing there, at what point did you really begin to see, even as a child, some of the magnificent type of ministry, the heavy type of ministry that he was doing?
Yeah, well, it actually started even before I actually can really remember anything, is just hearing stories about, for instance, the week that I was born. We were living in a small town in Pennsylvania, and my dad wasn't at the hospital. My mom had me without his assistance, which is very different in our generation. We always have to be there holding our wife's hands. But so he wasn't there. He was in New York City. And the same week that he was preaching to a group of gang members in New York City, the Mau Maus was one of them. It's from the book The Cross and Switchblade. Nicky Cruz gave his life to Jesus that week. And so to this day, when I see Nicky Cruz, he asks me how old I am, and he just gives me a big hug and says, you know, the week that you were born to your mother, I'm so thankful that your dad wasn't there. He was in New York City sacrificing family time for a gang member, 16-year-old gang member on the streets. And so we kind of celebrate a birthday together, his spiritual, mind, physical. And years later now, going way down the line, 50 years later, I'm a pastor in Colorado Springs. Nicky Cruz also lives in Colorado Springs, and he attends my church, which is pretty fun.
That is amazing. That is phenomenal. Yeah. So at what point did you really recognize that God had a call for you, not necessarily to follow your father's footsteps and do the same type of ministry, but to actually go in and do ministry work?
It was at a very young age. My dad used to take me to the Teen Challenge Center in Brooklyn. There'd be 30 or 40 ex-gang members, ex-drug addicts playing basketball, and I'd spend the day with them, and I just got to see their life change. The day they'd come in, you could see they'd be, and I didn't really understand it at 6 or 7 years old, but they were all strung out on heroin, looked like they were dead, and then to be there every day a few weeks later to see them with joy on their faces and starting to gain some health and out there playing basketball. So I knew that from a very young age that God has power to change lives, no matter how terrible a situation somebody finds themselves in, that whatever desperation, God's big enough to meet that need. And I just said, now that would be a great way to spend your life, wouldn't it, to help people in a crisis. So then a few years later, I was hearing him preach. I think I was probably 12 at the time. I was hearing him preach out in California to this was back in the day when the Jesus movement was taking place. A lot of hippies and barefoot kids with long hair, and they were all coming to the altar, giving their life to Christ. And I just knew, and that's what I want to do with my life. I want to see people come to know and love Jesus. So it was I think it was his faith became contagious to me, seeing that if you really believe God, he could do the impossible, then he could use you. And he's used me in a very different way. My dad didn't have much of a sense of humor. I'm a little bit more on that edge of things. I'm kind of casual. He was very formal. I think it's great just to be who you are. That's one of the things my dad always told me. He said, don't try to be like me. Don't try to be like any other minister. Be yourself. Do what you're called to do. So that's a great joy to just be yourself. Yeah.